I needed footwear, but I didn't have much dough. So I went across the border into old Mexico. I found some shiny cowboy boots, and they looked really neat. The boots I bought in Mexico, they really hurt my feet.
The boots he bought in Mexico, they really hurt his feet.
I thought I'd go out dancing with the girl that I love so. We danced a while and then she says, "Earl, why are you dancing slow?" I said, "I've got a problem here, my feet don't wanna go. They're hurting in them cowboy boots I bought in Mexico.
They're hurting in them cowboy boots he bought in Mexico."
Talk about corns and bunions and blisters that I had. I was in a real hurt, the pain was pretty bad. I threw them out in the corral under the horse's feet. Maybe that'll stretch the leather on the boots that hurt my feet.
Maybe that will stretch the leather on the boots that hurt his feet.
If I could, I'd never walk, I'd ride my horse all day. The guy that made those cowboy boots, he surely ought to pay. Oh, I've suffered so much pain, big blisters on my toe, and I'm still wearing cowboy boots I bought in Mexico.
And he's still wearing cowboy boots he bought in Mexico.
I wasn't getting anywhere, I can't believe my luck. To soften them, I run over them with my pickup truck. Now my boots have two tire tracks, and my morale is low. And I'm still wearing cowboy boots I bought in Mexico.
And he's still wearing cowboy boots he bought in Mexico.
Next time I buy some cowboy boots, a big iron on my hip, I'll tell the man, "Soft ones, please, don't you give no lip." If I find boots that feel good, there's one thing that I know. I'll throw away those cowboy boots I bought in Mexico.
He really hates those cowboy boots he bought in Mexico.